Arthur C. Clarke, author of 2001: A Space Odyssey, once said, "Two possibilities exist. Either we are alone in the universe, or we are not. Both are equally terrifying." Most media exploring the topic of alien life in the universe often work from the assumption that we are not alone, and that our technology is not sufficiently advanced to detect our distant neighbors, or that they know we're here and don't think we're worth contacting, or any number of other explanations. While these hypotheses may turn out to be true, the other possibility that doesn't get as much attention is that we are in fact alone in the universe. If that were the case, how would it change our lives and our goals here on Earth? For this thought experiment, we're going to assume that humanity has a way to accurately determine that we are the only life forms in the universe, and work from there. If one day the news broke that the universe is indeed a cold, dead place, and that all life is contained here on Earth, it would instantly bring to mind two possibilities. Either we are the very first life in the universe, or the very last. And knowing humanity's affinity for giant explosives, we could very easily be the first and last life in the universe if we weren't careful. Besides our new terrifying realization that we're one planet away from a completely sterile universe, what would change? Let's start with the world's space programs. If we were alone in the universe, we could scrap any missions designed to search for extraterrestrial life. That would include numerous probes, such as those intended for the icy landscapes of Europa and Enceladus, as well as entire branches of national space programs like the SETI Institute. We could use the money from those programs to redouble our efforts in preserving the Earth and its natural resources, or to fund new schools, hospitals, or humanitarian organizations. Of course, that's probably wishful thinking, but the possibility is there. If we wanted to keep that money in the space programs, we could put it towards research and development of ways to ensure humanity's continued survival in the event of disaster on Earth. Colonies on the Moon, Venus, Mars, or even prototype generational ships that could support human colonies over several lifetimes would be worthwhile endeavors. Of course, with an announcement of such magnitude, it would no doubt create polarized groups within our global society. As the only intelligent life in the universe, would it be our responsibility to seed life on other planets by sending probes full of bacteria and simple organisms? Or are we no more than a blight on the universe that should be contained to Earth? Given our history of colonization on Earth, it would stand to reason that we would at least want to establish colonies as far away from Earth as possible, if only to ensure the survival of our species in the event of a gamma ray burst or some other cataclysm. But seeding life on other planets we'll likely never visit would probably be met with controversy. So far, we've been working under the assumption that we are the only life in the universe at all. But what if we specified that we were the only intelligent life? How would that change the scenario? Well, if we assume again that humanity has a way to determine that there is no intelligent life in the universe, then not much will change initially. However, imagine a scenario in which a probe from Earth discovers single-celled life on another planet, let's say Europa. In this scenario, we would be the billions of years more advanced alien species keeping an eye on new life in the universe, something that many people have suspected extraterrestrials have been doing to us over the history of life on Earth. But what would we do about it? To what extent would we interfere with the growth of a new presence in the universe? Many would argue that the best course of action would be to observe from afar, and allow nature to run its course, no matter the outcome. Others might want to watch, but take it one step further, and intervene if the new life is headed for catastrophe. Then there will most likely be a portion of society that thinks we should physically visit Europa and try to guide the life forms to success. A dangerous proposition, as humans would carry microbes with them that could endanger the very life we're trying to protect. As one final possibility, what if we were to discover the presence of a very primitive species just starting to use simple tools? This would be the truest test of humanity's disposition towards extraterrestrial life. As with the previous scenario, we could look to the zoo hypothesis for one example of how best to handle fledgling life forms. The zoo hypothesis suggests that intelligent civilizations would refrain from visiting planets with life to allow natural evolution and sociocultural development. It certainly seems like the most respectful way to handle the situation, and it's not too much of a stretch of the imagination to think that most world leaders could agree to contact these extraterrestrials only once they had reached a certain technological or societal threshold. Of course, there would be others who would want to visit them immediately, and, I don't know, build pyramids or something. While this may not seem like an important topic to discuss, it allows us to explore several interesting issues. How would our space programs change if we were the only life in the universe? Would we scrap them entirely and just focus on our existence here on Earth? Or would we reallocate those funds to focus on something more like an escape plan? Would a newfound certainty of uniqueness in the universe prompt us to become a more peaceful species? Or would life go on the way it always has? If we discovered we were not completely alone, but at the top of the totem pole of intelligence, would we act like the curators of an intergalactic zoo? Would we play the role of a benevolent god race, intervening to prevent disaster, guiding life towards civilization? Or would we do the unthinkable, and ensure that no life forms ever become advanced enough to threaten our position as the apex predator of the cosmos? These are only a handful of the questions this topic can raise, and who knows if we'll ever be able to answer them. Only time will tell. Leave your thoughts and opinions in the comments below. Hopefully we can spark some interesting conversations, and maybe explore those ideas in future videos. If you enjoyed this video, check out this playlist of all my other space-related content. Or, if you're really bored, you can watch all my videos by clicking here. Make sure to subscribe if you haven't already, follow Second Thought on your favorite social media, and leave a comment down below with your opinions on today's thought experiment. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.